time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Tuck it and run. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and four and second and eight and nine.
They'll come up now, second and four from the 31.
Check, 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 check. Check, check, check. Wait. He's checking, he's checking, he's checking.
Stepping up, he's going to keep it. He'll get two on the keeper, but it becomes now a third down.
I think when people start talking about the greatest Ravens of all time, Ray Lewis's name comes up pretty fast, doesn't it? Tackles like that, just the tip of the iceberg when you start to talk about his talents.
He was their second pick after the move to Baltimore. What was that, 96?
Yeah, 1996. Jonathan Ogden was the first.
And Ray Lewis also two-time Super Bowl champion and the MVP of Super Bowl 35. This time, Jackson will throw it. Jordan Reed has it. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Dolphin first down.
They brought in a heavy set on third down, and that usually means running play, but we have seen them throw out of that formation. And sure enough, they snuck the tight end out on that one, wound up hitting him for a first down.
It's Jackson. Takes to midfield, but no further. Just a yard there.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they were hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine.
Get him. Check, check. Lucky, lucky, lucky.
Now this time he'll look to throw. Jackson hit, and he lost the football. And the Packers pick it up. Weaving through traffic, and now he's free. And he will bring this one back. A fumble return for a Green Bay touchdown. And give some kudos to the defensive coordinator, I think, here. They bring the blitz, they dial it up, and it turns into 6 points for them.
It's so nice to hear you actually give kudos to the defense. It is so nice. You're such an offensive guy like that. I love it. He dialed things up, and boy, a big play resulted for his guys.
Well, you like the credit to the defense there, right, my friend?
Yeah, do I ever.
So here's the kickoff now as they'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. Stepping up, he's going to keep it, and he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just just a three-yard gain there.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Here's second and seven now from the 28.
He's crashing. He's checking crack. Back, back, back. Hey, defense, let's go. Pick it up, D.
Six times he went over 1,000 yards. Here's Clinton Portis. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. Plays like we just saw there. That's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs who are putting together a team, a lot of them say we're going to build from the inside out, because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game. And that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
And now a timeout coming from the defensive side for the Packers. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Jackson fakes the give and keeps it. That's complete to his running back, Portis. And they're going to get him down well short of the first, as he can only get this to the 30. Instead of throwing it downfield, Charles, they just tried to dump it underneath there. You like the call?
I do. I think it's a high percentage play because you get the completion. What you're counting on is your back to use his legs and his elusiveness to make people miss and pick up the first down. In this case, it didn't happen.
So on fourth down, they bring on the Michigan man, Matt Wild, to kick it away. This is fielded at the 27. 21 yards. Well done on the return. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10, just shy of midfield at the 48. All that, and it only nets them a yard. It's second down. Now a five-time All-Pro. Here's Gale Sayers. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 12 yards there and a first down. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Here's Locke, buying time to his left. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. The Packers with the football here to begin the second quarter as they are looking at a second down and 6 coming up. Sayers right side. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 11 yards there, first down.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
Right back to him on first down. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll be stopped after a gain of only a couple down to the 15-yard line.
But we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and throwing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. Hammering for the goal line. He loses the football.
Wow. That ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's 2nd and goal. On the run, it's Bo Jackson. And he'll take this one in for a Packer touchdown. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Packers are able to stretch that lead out further. Extra point by Stinnerud, up and good. And that'll make the score 14-0. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points, get that 0 off the board. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a 2nd and 11. Jackson. It's complete to Hopkins. They'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for 3rd down. Right. 2 minutes to play, 1st half. It's 14-0. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have highlights and analysis of this first half of action. He may try and run for this, and he's able to get the 1st before he's taken down at the 36. He'll grab 3 yards on the play, taking it himself for the 1st down. So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. From the gun, it's Jackson. It's caught by Jackson. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. They only got 1 yard out of that last completion, and that makes this 2nd and 9. To throw is Jackson. The 1st catch of the game for George Kittle. Big yardage after the catch. That one winds up going for 36. For an offense that has not found the end zone yet, that's a big play.
There's the spark right there. The big play that they needed. Now they've got to go ahead and finish this drive and put this ball in the end zone.
So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, 1st and 10. Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. That one goes for 24 yards. 2 big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's 1st and goal. And he takes it into the end zone for the Dolphin touchdown. Lamar Jackson, a 3-yard run as he kept it himself. As they are now on the board here in the 1st half. this one was going, you just got the sense they needed something before half. They've at least got something on the board now. Still trailing, but a good sign.
That takes me back to our preseason tour of NFL camps. You remember we talked with that one coach who said his emphasis this year was scoring in the last 2 minutes of a half, heading into the locker room. This hits it right there. Take that momentum, take that good feeling, and take the locker room, regroup, and start over. They got it here.
They did indeed. A lot of football, full half to be played. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. You're under a minute to go here in the half. Field position not really in your favor, but still time to try and move the ball and get in field goal range.
Yeah, you've got the lead. It's definitely a thought. Let's go ahead and try and increase it. But at the same time, I don't like the odds. I don't like where they are in the field. Got the lead. They've done well in the first half. Don't mess it up and go into halftime looking at each other wondering what if.
On first and 10, Locke. Throw left side complete. It's Holt. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. A really nice gain of 25 yards. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Now it's Locke. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Holt. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15. 14 yards, good for a Packer first down. Here's Locke. And he's got it. A 14-yard pickup. That's 14 yards on two straight plays. Seems as if the passing attack starting to heat up a little bit here in the second quarter.
You can sense and you can see the momentum because now they're reading their patterns downfield. They're understanding the coverages. And they're finding the open holes in the defense.
Check out. Wide, 6-3. Walk. Check nickel.
Hey, high seven.
Motion. High 50, Mike.
Quote.
And watch the slant.
Throwing again is Locke. Touchdown, Packers. George Kittle there to make the grab. And the Packers are able to stretch that lead out further. And that'll give them a two-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here of the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
Extra point by Stenerud, up and good. And it's now 21-7. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This is taken at the 3. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. We're under 20 seconds to go in the half. I'm guessing the wise play here is be safe.
That is the wise play because if you think about trying to fool them here, here's what you're facing. You're facing a loosened up secondary, playing a lot deeper than normal. So even if you run some type of misdirection, you're only going to fool them for a second or so. And guess what? They're so deep, they're really not going to be out of position. Take the knee, get to the locker room.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Jackson fakes the give and keeps it. And that'll be incomplete with 11 seconds remaining now. Clinton Portis, the intended receiver, out of the backfield. And that'll bring up second down. Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10.
Safety's creeping. Go.
Now Jackson, going to throw again. Into a double team and it's intercepted. It's the former Seahawk, Earl Thomas. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. Try to get one more in here before the quarter breaks.
Hey, watch the slip.
The final shot before the break. Lock. And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of his first half of play. So we have come to halftime in what's already a two-touchdown game. As we send you up to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. So it's the Packers set to receive the kick. They've got the lead as well as we are underway in the third quarter. This will be taken short. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. And he finally goes down, but not before reaching the 21. It's a big play there for Green Bay. 48 yards. Love dancing to his left. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now a give, right side, Jackson. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. A gain of 13, it's a first down. A lot to praise on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done.
Doesn't matter what play is called, they are handling their business at the line of scrimmage and dominating right now on this drive.
And he will get this into the end zone. Touch. sports coverage of the National Football League brings us to legendary Lambeau Field in Green Bay. We all know this community lives for its Packers, and the green and gold came out of the tunnel a short time ago, and it was loud. We are ready for football, so are they, as the Packers get set to match up with the Baltimore Ravens. This fielded at the two. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line.
Let's go, let's go.
Stack him up right at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the game's first play. And it's down now.
No gain on the play. Second and 10 at the 20-yard line.
The stop for no gain brings up second and 10 from the 20. Jackson from the shotgun. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
Used to have a coach just tell us all the time, those scouting reports aren't just to use up paper, guys. Well, nowadays, you know, we're watching a computer screen, right? They scouted this team very well. Know that they like to use the running backs in the passing game. They covered that play successfully.
Jackson. And that'll wind up incomplete. Bold play call there. Now it's fourth down.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
Fielded at the 20. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber who runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they're in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there, and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front and linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense, because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
The tackle made by L.J. Ford.
That didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
Here's Jones. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down. They're able to convert with a gain of four. All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. On the ground, this is Williams. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. 6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four. Jones. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. Give them 14 on that one and a first down. We're scoreless after one. Back for the second quarter in Green Bay. It's the Packers in possession of the football as they've got it with a first and 10. And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well. Consecutive plays now where that offensive line has really created a lot of space.
And we've seen the confidence rise, haven't we? It borders on arrogance now, and that's that good arrogance, believing you can run the football whenever you get good and ready.
57, come on. Get ready.
Rodgers with a keeper, and he'll take this into the end zone for a Green Bay touchdown. Aaron Rodgers keeping it himself on the quarterback sneak. And they are able to strike first here on their opening drive. Extra point up and good by Crosby. And that makes the score 7-0. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
And on the first drive, three and out. And I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically what I've heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have nerves at the start of a game, it's not going to be a great day for you. You're not really ready to play. So finding a way to harness those nerves and not let them affect you in a negative way, that's what all the guys are looking for.
On second and 11 now, Jackson, and a big loss here as he's taken down. Well, there was second long, now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going in the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
Now after that sack, it's third and long for Jackson and the Ravens. They go screen. This is Ingram. And he will lose yardage here back to his own six. It's a loss of a full 3 yards, and it brings up fourth down. Here's Sam Cook now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. So the directional kicking problematic there. They're going to spot this inside the 30-yard line. On first and 10, here's Rodgers. Got an open man. It's Valdez Scantling. And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard line. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal. They'll try again with Jones. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. Calling a gain of 2 as they're knocking on the door now. Third and goal. Here's Jones. No gain on the play that time. So a big stop, and it's going to leave him with a 4th and goal.
Let's think here. You're still just in the second quarter. You taking the 3 points?
Washington. I'm just relying on my defense here. Show them you have a little confidence in them and let the offense know. Nice drive. Come back next time. We'll go get six then. But for now, we'll take the three.
He will be brought down well shy of the goal line. They pass up the three, fake it. It doesn't work. And the Ravens come up big down at their own goal line. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Well, what's the plan of attack here? Very late second quarter, and look where the ball is.
Yeah, a bad spot for you. But the defense has all three timeouts. So what you're telling your team is ball security number one. It's not all on the running backs if you decide to run the football. That offensive line has got to protect them and wedge out some space because you can't just kneel. They take three timeouts. They're going to get the ball back in good field position with a chance to put points on the board. You've got to try and get a first down and run out this first half.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Inside of a minute left in the half, does the fact that you're down on the scoreboard influence what you do or, I guess, don't do on this final drive?
It certainly does, but what influences me even more is who I've got running my football team out on the field and the weapons around him. Can he make a play? Can he get into someone that we're going to trust to take care of the ball? If that's the case, I might push it a little bit here and try and get something before the half runs out.
Got a man. It's Brown. That one goes for 30 yards.
It's not a surprise when you read scouting reports and watch tape because you know he's a heck of a player. But he is so difficult to get down in the open field. They just want to get him the ball and let him do his thing.
Much more room to operate under after the big play. Here's first and 10. Keeper, and it'll be second down. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts as it'll come with 36 ticks to go in half number one. Get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Ravens going to use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. From the gun, Jackson. That's into the hands of Edwards. No gain, and it's second down. Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. And an alley to run! And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. It's a first down on a gain of 10. Now Justin Tucker. He has hit from 61 in his career, so he has the leg for this. This will be spotted just shy of midfield. A 59-yard attempt. Online, but off the crossbar, no good. A long-range effort denied 3 points at the very end. So we've reached halftime with just the lone touchdown here. 7-0 is our score. As we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, this will be taken very short. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30.
set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. To throw, it's Rodgers. Blitz coming, and down he goes.
We are seeing two really confident defenses imposing their will on these offenses in this game.
Yeah, absolutely, going toe for toe. Just curious if one of these offenses can wake up a little bit.
Is there any way they can find something that can pop, something big?
Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Tyus Bowser, he's the one to get him this time, and back-to-back sacks brings up fourth down. Here's J.K. Scott now, standing about a yard deep in his own end zone. And he gets it away, and it's a laser headed for the sidelines. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
16 yards on that one at a Raven first.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
Stepping up, he's going to keep it. It'll be a pickup of 5 on the keeper. It's second down. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you, because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. No gain on the play, and it'll bring up a third down.
And that's when it's fun to play defense. When you're able to diagnose a play right from the beginning, get all your guys to the football, and spill the play, that's when you have a lot of fun playing on that side of the ball.
They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all, and now they're looking at third down here. Jackson from the gun, he'll throw, and that is incomplete. Another drive comes and goes, still nothing on the scoreboard.
Yeah, and when the second half comes, you know, it's real easy to get discouraged and wonder if you're ever going to get things started. You just got to fight through it, got to keep pounding away.
They'll indeed go for it with Jackson. Trying for Brown, and it's intercepted. Adrian Amos with a pick. And he'll get it all the way down inside the 35-yard line.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this. On second down, it's Jones. And down.
seen. He goes 11 yards there. First down.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. Fourth quarter, you've got the lead. You have to stay in bounds and run that clock. Coaches, that'll drive them crazy.
Sacrifice a yard or two if you have to. Just go down.